strings built-in functions. So there are several library functions defined which will be working on the string. So here we are having a list of some of them. So we are having the function like strcpy. This is a function strcpy which takes two string input arguments, so s1 and s2. So copy string s2 onto the string s1. Strcat, this word has come from the word concatenation. So concatenation means you are adding two strings. So strcat s1 s2 which concatenates string s2 onto the end of the string s1. So the first string and the second string, so the second string will be appended back to the first string. Strlen s1, it takes only one string variable, so returns the length of the string. Strcmp, which compares s1 and s2, it returns 0 if s1 and s2 are same, and it returns non-zero value if s1 and s2 are not equal. Strchr s1ch returns a pointer to the first occurrence of the character ch in the given string s1. Strstr, that is s1 s2, returns a pointer to the first occurrence of the substring s2 in the main string s1. So these are the different list of functions and their respective purposes. So here we have written one code using some of these discussed functions here. So here we are having one string, that is hello in str1. There is another string world kept in str2, and str3 is another uninitialized string. So it is nothing but one character array. So now int len, another variable we have defined. Strcpy, str3, str1. So strcpy means what? Means the string copy. So in the str3, which was void initially, having uninitialized, no prior string. So there I'm putting this str1 here. So if I want to print str3, then I'm supposed to get hello as an output. Let me check. Strcpy str3 str1 is giving me the value hello. So now we are doing the strcat. I told you that cat means cat. Cat stands, it has come from the word string concatenation. Concatenation, from that word cat came. So strcat str1 str2. So str1 is containing hello and str2 is containing world. So now str1, at the end of str1, str2 will be concatenated. So now if I print this str1, I'm supposed to get this hello world as output. So we are getting hello world as output, and there is no gap between hello and world because hello is having terminated by double quotes without having any blank at the end, and also there is no blank space prior to this particular string world. So that's why hello world came without having any blank space in between. We're having another one, there is a len, strlen str1. So we are calculating the length of this. So now str1 is holding the hello world. So hello is having 5 letters, world is having 5 letters, so hello world is having 10 letters. So this len will get initialized with the value 10. So whenever you are supposed to print this len, I'm supposed to get this 10 here. In this way, this C++ code, if I execute, what will be the output that I have shown here? So now it is your homework, that is, please type this code, check this output, and apply other string library functions in your code for the better understanding. Thanks for watching this video.